Something wrong?
A kink in my back. That's it. A little higher, please. Push. Push hard. Take it in there, Mr. Spock. Thank you, gentlemen. That's sufficient.
Dr. McCoy is correct, Captain. After what this ship has been through in the last 3 months, there's not a crewman aboard who's not in need of a rest. Myself excepted, of course. Captain, I'll go back aboard ship and take over. With all due respect to the young lady, I've already had as much shore leave as I care for.
Yeah.
Spock.
Come in. Yes, Mr. Spock, what is it?
Is there something I can do for you, Captain?
Like what?
Well, Dr. McCoy seemed to think that I should check on you.
That's nice. Come on, Spock, I know that look. What is it?
Well, our good doctor said that you were acting like a wild man demanded brandy.
Our good doctor's been putting you on again.
Well, in that case, if you'll excuse the intrusion, Captain, I'll get back to my work.
I'll tell him you were properly annoyed.
Captain.
And from my observations, it seems they're bisexual.
Logical precaution, Captain. The Sherman's Planet affair is of extreme importance to the Federation.
Back to Enterprise.
May I inquire as to our course, Captain?
Benicia Colony.
Benicia Colony is 8 light-years off our course.
My memory needs refreshing, Mr. Spock. I'll ask you for it. In the meantime, follow my orders.
Most curious creature, Captain. Its trilling seems to have a tranquilizing effect on the human nervous system. Fortunately, of course, I am immune to its effect.
Something I did come to discuss.
Yes, Mr. Spock, please.
I picked this up from Dr. McCoy's log. We have a crew member aboard who's showing signs of stress and fatigue. Reaction time down 9 to 12%. Associational rating norm -3.
That's much too low a rating.
He's becoming irritable and quarrelsome, yet he refuses to take rest and rehabilitation. Now, he has that right, but we found...
Crewman's right ends when the safety of the ship begins. Now, that man will go ashore on my orders. What's his name?
James Kirk. Enjoy yourself, Captain. It's an interesting planet. I believe you'll find it quite pleasant. I don't believe that, neither do you. I want the captain to see that report when I've finished logging it. Now. All right. A time portal, Captain. A gateway to other times and dimensions, if I'm correct.
As correct as possible for you. Your science knowledge is obviously primitive.
Really?
Annoyed, Spock?
A computer capable of directing the lives of millions of human beings.
But only a machine, Mr. Spock. The original Landru programmed it with all his knowledge, but he couldn't give it his wisdom, his compassion, his understanding, his soul, Mr. Spock.
Predictably metaphysical. I prefer the concrete, the graspable, the provable.
You'd make a splendid computer, Mr. Spock.
That is very kind of you, Captain.
Captain?
We have a flock.
We have a what, Captain?
A place to sleep.
One might have said so in the first place.
We seem to be costumed a little out of step with the time.
I'm afraid I'm going to be difficult to explain in any case, Captain.
Well, Mr. Spock, if we can't disguise you, we'll find some way of explaining you.
That should prove interesting.
You're actually enjoying my predicament back there. At times, you seem quite human.
Captain, I hardly believe that insults are within your prerogative as my commanding officer.
Sorry.
Those that kill Heindorf, see the stuff on the end?
Mm.
It's like sapling, only it's 1,000 times stronger.
Kill your stuff to find a paradise.
Jim! Spock!
You all right?
Dr. McCoy's potion is acting like all his potions, turning my stomach. Other than that, I am quite well.
Just what do you think you were trying to do?
I surmised you were unaware of that plant, so I...
stepped in front and took the thorns yourself.
I assure you, Captain, I had no intention of doing that. It was merely my own clumsiness which prevented me from moving out of the way.
I see. Well, next time, just yell. I can step out of the way as quickly as the next man.
I shall do so.
Gonna get yourself killed. Do you know how much Starfleet has invested in you?
122,200.
Never mind.
Captain, I must have some platinum. A small block would be sufficient, 5 or 6 pounds. By passing certain circuits through there to be used as a duodynetic field core.
And Mr. Spock, I've brought you some assorted vegetables, bologna and a hard roll for myself.
And I've spent the other 9/10 of our combined salaries for the last 3 days on filling this order for you. Mr. Spock, this bag does not contain platinum, silver, or gold, nor is it likely to in the near future.
Captain, you're asking me to work with equipment which is hardly very far ahead of stone knives and bearskins.
McCoy will be along in a few days. Perhaps sooner. There's no guarantee that these currents in time will bring us together.
I am endeavoring, ma'am, to construct a mnemonic memory circuit using stone knives and bearskins.
Fine, Joe. I'm out of there. Mr. Spock. Your pulse is 242. Your blood pressure is practically non-existent. Assuming you call that green stuff in your veins blood.
The readings are perfectly normal for me, Doctor. Thank you. And as for my anatomy being different from yours, I am delighted.
Couldn't you build some form of computer aid here?
In this zinc-plated, vacuum-tubed culture.
Yes, well, it would pose an extremely complex problem in logic, Mr. Spock.
Live long, T'Pau. And prosper.
Live long and prosper, Spock.
I shall do neither. I have killed my captain. And my friend. There can be no excuse. The crime of which I'm guilty, I intend to offer no defense. Furthermore, I shall order Mr. Scott to take immediate command of this vessel.
Don't you think you better check with me first?
Captain. Jim! I'm pleased to see you, Captain. You seem uninjured. I am at something of a loss to understand it, however.
But the girl, the wedding.
Oh, yes, the girl. Most interesting. It must have been the combat. When I thought I had killed the captain, I found I had lost all interest in Tupring. The madness was gone.
I believe we have about a week before McCoy arrives, but we can't be certain.
Arrived where? Honolulu, Boise, San Diego? Why not Outer Mongolia, for that matter?
There's a theory. There could be some logic to the belief that time is fluid, like a river with currents, eddies, backwash.
McCoy, to a certain time and place, might sweep us there, too.
Yes, that is true, Captain. We have no hope.
You can't tell me that when you first saw Jim alive, that you weren't on the verge of giving us an emotional scene that would have brought the house down.
Merely my quite logical relief that Starfleet had not lost the highly proficient captain.
Yes, Mr. Spock, I understand.
Thank you, Captain.
Of course, Mr. Spock. Your reaction was quite logical.
Thank you, Doctor.
In a pig's eye.
Come on, Spock. Let's go mind the store.
It does something for you.
Yes, indeed it does, Captain. It makes me uncomfortable.
I'm Sayana.
Second degree burns. Not serious, but I bet they're smart.
Doctor, you have an unsurpassed talent for understatement.
An amazing example of Hodgkin's law of parallel planet development. But on this Earth...
We'll wait here until dark.
Runaway slaves are always welcome. Oh, not slave. Barbarian. It's been a long time since I've watched barbarians die in the arena.
Spock, is that you?
Captain. Captain Kirk.
Yes, Spock. Yes.
Captain, there is a definite pleasurable experience connected with the hearing of your voice.
Where are you, Spock?
Is that you, Dr. McCoy? And are you with the captain?
Where else would I be?
Mr. Spock, where are you?
Engineer Scott as well. Unfortunately, I do not know where I am.
We'll get you, Spock. It won't be long.
I doubt if he'll get very far. He feels ill.
I do.
Outside.
All right, but he'll double over before we get very far.
Oh, I think I can walk. I'll try.
Ooh!
Please believe me. I do appreciate it.
A remarkable example of a retrograde civilization at the peak, advanced beyond any of our capabilities, and now operating at this primitive level which you saw. And it all began thousands of years ago when a glacial age reoccurred. A fascinating cultural development of a kind
I
which
knew it was wrong.
I shouldn't have done it.
What's that?
I should have never reconnected his mouth.
Well, we took the risk, Doctor.
As I was saying, a fascinating cultural development of a kind which hasn't been seen in ages. The last such occurrence to...
I know you. All of you.
James Kirk. Captain and friend for many years. And Leonard McCoy. Also of long acquaintance. She walks in beauty like the night.
That's not Spock.
Are you surprised to find that I've read Byron, Doctor?
That's Spock. You are beautiful.
Is it so wrong to tell you so?
Like you to give up trying.
And I'll repeat it for you. Get this through your head. We can't get back. That means we are trapped here in this planet's past, just as we are. And we'll stay here for the rest of our lives. Now, do you understand?
Yes, I understand. I never thought I'd hear it. But I understand. You want to stay here.
As a matter of fact, you are highly motivated to stay in this forsaken waste.
The prospect appeared quite attractive to you a moment ago.
Now you listen to me, you pointed-eared Vulcan.
I don't like that. I don't think I ever did, and now I'm sure.
What's happening to you, Spock?
Nothing that shouldn't have happened long ago.
It seems they're bisexual.
In this severe cold, we cannot survive much longer.
Leave me here, Spock.
We go together or not at all?
Don't be a fool. My hands and face are frostbitten. I can't feel my feet. Alone, you have a chance. Now do what I say. Go try to find Jim.
We go together.
You stubborn, thick-headed Vulcan.
Such emotions are foreign to me, Doctor. I'm merely testing the strength of the door. For the 15th time. Spock, I know we've had our disagreements. Maybe they're jokes. I don't know. As Jim says, we're not often sure ourselves sometimes, but what I'm trying to say is... Doctor, I'm seeking a means of escape. Will you please be brief? Well, what I'm trying to say is you saved my life in the arena.
Yes, that's quite true.
I'm trying to thank you, you pointed-eared hobgoblin.
Oh, yes, you humans have that emotional need to express gratitude. You're welcome, I believe, is the correct response. However, Doctor, you must remember that I'm entirely motivated by logic. The loss of our ship's surgeon, whatever I may think of his relative skill, would mean a reduction in the efficiency of the Enterprise, and therefore...
No lying. You're not afraid to die, Spock. You're more afraid of living. Each day you stay alive is just one more day you might slip and let your human half peek out. That's it, isn't it? And security. Why, you wouldn't know what to do with a genuine, warm, decent feeling.
Really, Doctor?
Are they dating now?
It seems they're bisexual.